Shereyashvili. And his opponent across the ring fighting out of the blue corner. He wears the black with the gold trim. He's scaled at already 60.8 kilos. His professional record, 10 victories, 1 defeat, with 2 wins coming by way of knockout. He fights out of Dubai, here in the United Emirates. Please welcome Kid Emirati Fahad Al-Blushi. Al-Blushi.
So first fight of the night here on Before the Bell, live from the Emirates Arena at Abu Dhabi. Welcome if you're just joining us. Chris Lloyd here alongside Darren Barker to take you through the next 4 contests. This one, a 6-rounder. Agreed at £135. Fahad Al-Blushi, the shorter figure of the two, the white gloves. Weighed in yesterday at £134. Irakli Shariashvili, the tall figure, languid, rangy. Was 134.7. Unorthodox, can hit you from any angle, but does leave himself open, Darren, and it'll be for Al-Blushi early to try and have a look at him, see where those openings lie.
Absolutely. I think when you're facing someone as tall as Shariashvili, the jab to the body's key. Variation with the jab, feints upstairs, jab to the body, vice versa. Just keep the Georgian thinking. Nice, crisp jab by Al-Blushi. He's a good fighter. He's switched on. He's got good reactions. He moves his feet out of range really well. He can occasionally switch off. I've seen him as rounds go on, does get caught with sloppy shots, but there's a lot to work with.
Struggling to get into range so far. Nice shot landed there.
It's a nice jab from Al-Blushi. Again, just targeting the head, I think dropping it down to the body.
Shariashvili is quite naturally quite a counter-puncher.
Yeah.
Just pulls the trigger on the right-hand counter over the jab. It was a nice glancing right hand that landed there for Al-Blushi.
Yeah, like I was saying in the ring walk there, he's a bit of a nightmare to pin down, Shariashvili. So you've got to be quick on the feet, you've got to cut that ring down, try and pin him into the corner.
Again,
right hand just missing, didn't it, there, Al-Blushi?
Yeah, looking to counter off the ropes, Shariashvili as well. And again, just raking in that left hand to the body. Does like to throw that as a kind of corkscrew uppercut as well.
Yep, just needs to be a bit quicker on his feet, Al-Blushi. He's letting his hands go before his feet move. And that's why he's just been out of range a couple of times. You see it again. Shariashvili can be a real nightmare. You see him moving side to side and he pounces in with 4 shots. Only 2 KOs on the record of Shariashvili, so there's not much power there.
Just lands a left hook there. Shariashvili replied with just 1 to the body, but the Emirati kid just keeping those elbows tucked down by his sides, patiently waiting, just looks for that jab to the body. And again, Shariashvili just pulls the trigger on that right-hand counter. Didn't miss by too much. Just trying to draw the lead with a feint and does so there. Not able to punish him that time. Just a couple of seconds to the end of round number 1. Fairly cagey opener. Little pockets of success for both fighters. And well, the kids from the local gym have been visited this week by Gilberto Ramirez, by Dimitri Bivol, Freddie Roach as well. Hard to understate the impact that will have had on them, their belief, just seeing some of their heroes in the flesh this week.
Oh, yeah, I mean, like I said, this is huge for Middle Eastern boxing. The fact that there's going to be professional boxing here on a regular occasions. It's so important that these guys not only win but look good. They've got an opportunity to get on these shows in the future and become stars. I mean, there's a lot to work with. I mean, I can't get into it too much now because it would take a bit of time, but it's grassroots that needs to be invested in. Eddie said he's going to do that. So, look, the future for Middle Eastern boxing is very bright, Chris.
So here we go then, round number two of six, as the fighters are brought to the centre of the ring. Patient start from Al Blushi and from Shariashvili as well, both trying to trigger each other off and counter. That was a nice little two-phase counter there from Al Blushi.
Yeah, it was a lovely right to the body. Shariashvili falling over his front foot. And lovely sharp shot, looking at that right hand over the top. He has to be careful with that jab. Shariashvili can't be pouring it out. We've seen on a couple of occasions Al Blushi, when he lets the shots go properly, they're quick, they're sharp, accurate. Just missing with the left hook there, Shariashvili.
Yeah, you can see him trying to line the uppercut too as well, because of the height discrepancy. And well, for the two or three occasions where he has been stopped early, to his credit, he went six with Kershaw Todjibayev, an Uzbek prospect who beat Joe Caldina at the Rio Games before he was eliminated by the eventual winner, Robson Conceição. So he does know what he's doing, and you can see why. Quite calm rhythm, doesn't overcommit himself, relaxed, hits you with unorthodox shots, and a natural counterpuncher as well. And a little bit of swag about him too. Ooh. He's very beatable, as that right hand just glances the top left of the head of the Georgian.
Yeah, Shariashvili doing what he usually does, frustrating his opponents. Blushi, he's boxing nicely. He just needs a bit more urgency on the feet. He needs to be quicker, closing that gap.
Just looking for that left-hand counter. Landed a couple there. One was to the head. Just another short one up the inside.
Just trying to up the tempo slightly, Al Blushi. And I think that's what he needs to do. Just go through the gears a little bit. Try and slow Shariashvili down.
Parrying that jab away. Just walking clockwise there into the path of the right hand. And Al Blushi just getting a little bit closer now in the second round. Yeah. Plenty of time to work with, remember, six rounds scheduled.
That's where he needs to start popping that jab out to the body. There you go. That's better. Just as I said it.
There you go.
You know, and look for the right hand over the top. You can see Shariashvili, every time he throws that jab to the body or he feints to the body, you get the reaction, the hands drop, and that's when you can look for the right hand over the top.
Or the left hook that he just landed there in that little exchange, as Shariashvili just ties him up again. Looks pretty comfortable so far, just starting to be on the kind of second best on these exchanges, as Al Blushi just walking him down, measuring that distance with a jab, falling short with the right hand. Long arms, isn't he? almost tie his shoelaces standing up, couldn't he? As he just turns, as he turns southward.
You're wrong there.
Oh, a little low that one, perhaps, from Al Blushi. No complaints there from Shariashvili. Two rounds in the books. Campbell Hatton and Akib Fiaz, two old stablemates from Northside Boxing Gym in the north of England. And they were young amateurs, will both be in action, looking to go 9 and 10 and 0 respectively in our next two fights. And it all leads, of course, later on tonight to the big one.
I've been waiting so long for this moment.
This is a big challenge for me.
These are the kind of fights that we need to see. WBA light heavyweight world championship between Dimitri Bivol and Zerdo Ramirez.
What a main event we've got coming up a little bit later on. The WBA World Light Heavyweight title, Dimitri Bivol defending his belt against the 44-0 Gilberto Ramirez. Can the giant southpaw Mexican apply pressure that we so rarely see Dimitri Bivol under? Reading a tweet from Dan Canobio's family, of course, set up CompuBox, just talking about the dominance, statistical dominance of Bivol. He's been outlanded in one round of his last 76. That was all the way back in 2018. He's got the highest jab land to connect percentage, pound for pound, in the modern day, ahead of even Shakur Stevenson. And he's the least hit fighter in the modern era as well. And while we talk about Gilberto Ramirez, Darren, being a volume puncher, lovely right hand lands there from Al Blushi. But the volume We can't expect Gilberto Ramirez to be landing in the same kind of differentials that he normally does because of what Dmitry Bivol does himself.
I mean, they're incredible stats. They really are. And again, proving why he's one of the main men out there, Bivol. Ramirez, it's a tough task. But like we said before, if you can get that jab, the right to the body, etc., into play, he's got a chance, but don't get much tougher. But Belushi, been a bit sloppy at the start of this third round. Been a bit wild with the right hand, looping over the top, and made it slightly easy for Shariasvili just to fire back with the counters. Nice right uppercut there, just grazing the target. He's growing in confidence, Shariasvili.
Well, he can be a bit of a bully. What a couple of subpar opposition, let's be perfectly honest, but it's been quite dominant. Fought a guy called Georgi Churubchiri, hurt him to the body, dropped him in the first round, finished him inside the first 3 minutes. It took him just two rounds to get rid of David Binzinashvili. Again, beat up his countryman who didn't come out for the third round. So when he fancies it, he's hitting you from shots that, from angles that you don't see. He can be dangerous. He fought a small southpaw called Achiko Odikadze a couple of years ago. And, well, he didn't unravel through any fault of his own. He dislocated his right shoulder. He was just caught with a kind of short uppercut on the inside and just popped the arm out. With limbs like that, you can kind of see why. But on his day, he can be a handful. So far, Al Belushi looks like he's just getting control of this contest as we near the end of round number three.
Yeah, he's just got to up the tempo. Sorry, Chris, Belushi. Not doing a lot wrong, really. There's a couple of clumsy mistakes, but he's just looking for the one shot. You see there, looking for the left hook. I think, you know, setting traps, a jab to the body, not to keep on about it, but feints, try and draw out the lead. But I think he's got to get closer, and you get closer by being more aggressive on that front foot.
Nice 1-2 there from Shariasvili. End of the round. Halfway point of our first contest of the evening. Two of the Yafai brothers in action a bit later on as well. Former world champion Cal and Olympic gold medalist younger brother Galau. All live on the zone in a couple of hours' time. And well, meanwhile, Farhad Al-Belushi, Darren, he's made a couple of mistakes in that last round, but by and large, he's in control through three.
Yeah, he is. I feel he just has to up the tempo, be more aggressive with the feet, like I say. Shariasvili, though, I don't think he'll be too disappointed with the way the fight's going. He's moving, he's making life difficult for Al Belushi, but he's not in any danger. And I think when you've got the sort of record that Shariasvili has, you just don't want to be getting hurt. And I think he's moving and doing what his job is supposed to be.
So into the second half of the contest then. Round 4 of 6. If you just join us, Farhad Al-Belushi from the UAE. In the black trunks trimmed with gold, the white gloves. And his opponent, Irakli Shariasvili from Rastavi in Georgia. Nice uppercut there. Look for the left hook behind it. And that just rushes Al-Belushi. Good start to the round from the Georgian.
Yeah, chin high as he come in there, just lucky to avoid a left hook.
Yeah, well, that's what he has been caught, been his kind of undoing, isn't it?
Again, you see there, typical example of what's been happening 9 times out of 10 with the jab of Al-Belushi, just falling short and he's just not bringing the feet in. Shariasvili leaning back, making it difficult. That's where you jab to the body. We've mentioned this plenty of times in the past. When you're in there with someone that leans back, that body stays exactly where it is. The head may be off target, but the body isn't. So jab the body, work the body of the taller man.
He's got that lead hand low, just trying to manoeuvre him around the outside of the ring. Find an opening, walked him onto a right hand in the first round as he was just moving clockwise. And now just taking the feet back and dropping that head off the line, keeping safe. Shariasvili's been in retreat for the last minute and 10 or so after a decent start to the round.
He's just Billy Joe Saunders like. Sees the right hand waving by.
Every fighter dreams of that moment, don't they?
They do, don't they?
Oh, a lovely little chopping right hand there from Al-Belushi, and Shariasvili just holds on. Referee separates them.
Look, he's far too comfortable for me, Shariasvili, and Al-Belushi has to put him under more pressure. He's just kind of in cruise control. Got up the gears, two phases, three phases. What I mean by that is two shots, go again, three shots, and again. Got to make someone like Shariasvili uncomfortable.
Yeah, because it looks like Shariasvili's kind of gone into, I mean, it's hardly survival mode because he's not under enough pressure, but he's decided he's not going to win this, so he's just taking as little damage as
yeah,
possible.
He's doing his thing. He's doing what he's more than capable of doing. And that's, I mean, there's a lovely little right uppercut and left hook by Shariasvili, but he's just, when he's made to be able to do as he pleases, as he is now, just moving at ease, he can really make it difficult for his opponents. And we've seen that against Al-Belushi. He just needs to be a bit more aggressive. Look, he's not doing a great deal wrong. It's just the lack of tempo for me. But that's not taking anything away from Shariasvili, who, let's get it right, he is a bit of a nightmare.
Just round the little right hand there. And nice. Then a left hook, nice right over the top,
yeah,
again.
Yeah, it was.
Decent finish to the round from the Georgian. Just turns Southport. Around the outside of the ring, just hands low. Just trying to bait Al-Belushi into something. But the Emirati not taking the bait. Four rounds then of six here in Abu Dhabi.
Oh, what a night we've got in front of us, Chris. I cannot wait. You look at it from the top of the card down to the chief support, the Zelfa Barrett Rakimov fight. I can't wait. Some familiar faces there. Neddy Hearn, he'd be proud of himself, wouldn't he, Chris, putting on this event.
Yeah, I mean, they formed a good relationship with the Sheikh here and the local authorities to build these kind of events. I think the consensus is that they'll be coming back next year.
Bring your sun cream, Chris.
You bring yours. And a crash helmet as well.
And a crash helmet, yeah. A suit of armour.
Especially if Joshua Bawazzi is driving. Like Lewis Hamilton, but without the skills. So a little delay before the start of round number five. And welcome to those of you that are just starting to tune in and join us. Chris Lloyd alongside Darren Barker here in Abu Dhabi at the Emirates Arena for Before the Bell. First of our scheduled contest this evening. Hard Al-Belushi on the right of your screen in the white gloves, the black trumps trimmed with gold. Irakli Shariasvili has come out looking like he fancies it in this round. He's behind on the cards, you'd imagine, by a fair stretch. Ooh. Just caught, catches a lovely chopping right hand, and that drew a reaction, didn't it?
Yeah, it was a lovely right hand over the top, but as you just pointed out there, Shariasvili really coming to fight at the start of this fifth round. A few uppercuts followed by the left hook, right hand, but his chin does rise when he lets his hands go, and you see that's when Al-Belushi has success, just missing with another right hand, taking the sting out of the shot. Shariasvili, who again, he's moved an awful lot in this fight.
And when he did hold his feet in trade, as you say, had the success, but was vulnerable. Probably got hit with the best clean shot of the contest so far. But again, just trying to stand and earn the respect of Al-Belushi. Again, just inches that front foot into range, measures with a jab, fires with the right hand.
Yeah, this is better, Chris. More aggression on that front foot, and he's changing the levels with the shot. You see moments before, a couple of straight rights to the body, then a jab to the head, just mixing it up, being unpredictable, making it hard for Shariasvili to read the shots coming his way.
Shariasvili just led with the right hand. Al-Belushi looked to counter, pushing him onto the back foot again just over a minute to go in this penultimate round. And Al-Belushi's just quicking those feet up now, just senses that the end is creeping a little closer now. He's only got one round to go after this, and Shariasvili just trying to, almost pointing, saying this is the direction I'm going to go, just trying to feint, give himself a little bit of space.
This is what I wanted to see, Chris. Look, he's not letting his hands go as much as I'd like, Al-Belushi, but that aggression on the front foot, I've said it time and time again through these five rounds, just a bit more aggression, stepping forward. This is better. Letting his hands go now. Oh, landing a left hook, a right uppercut, followed by shots to the body. Better work. It's been a good fifth round, this, Al-Belushi. Best round yet.
trying to chop away at the body, and Shariashvili trying to smother his work with just over 10 seconds to go in round number five. Just for the first time in the contest, he looks like he's starting to feel the pace of it. Just a little short right up close when they were exchanging in the first minute of the contest. Just looked like it buzzed him a little bit, certainly lifted up, and you just saw his eyes a little wide, and he stepped immediately off around the outside of the ring and just went into a little bit more of a negative posture and just gone a little flatter in these last 30, 45 seconds or so. And our Blushi now just stepping on him. Shariashvili looking to get to the end of the round, try and recover in 60 seconds and rally for the final 3 minutes.
Yeah, good round for our Blushi. Best round for him yet. You can see he was happy with that round. Doing exactly what I was asking for, pushing forward on that front foot, letting his hands go, enjoying his boxing. Nice jabs. That was all headhunting there, but there was good changes of levels with the shot. There was one of them straight right to the body, and again. And when you're someone like Shariashvili, that makes it hard work for you. You know, you can't read what's coming your way. Good work to the body, the tempo, and just generally making it uncomfortable for the Georgian.
Yeah, he's physically looks quite strong as well. Just saw a little passenger play there, and Shariashvili just tried to push him back and wasn't able to kind of extend the levers and take him off balance. Not a big guy, is he, our Blushi, but physically strong, low centre of gravity, and not being pushed around here. So it's been a good five rounds for that man on your screen there. The Emirati kid, he's enjoyed himself.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the sixth and final round.
Sixth and final round.
And he is in full control as we head into the final round here. In our first contest in Abu Dhabi.
Let's see if he can close the show in style. Entertain his home supporters. Started well, mixing up that jab, throwing the right to the body. See if he can really let his hands go. But again, Shariashvili.
Defensively, he's been good to our Blushi. When Shariashvili's tried to spring off the ropes in combinations, he's thrown four or five shots at a time, but all of them have missed. He just makes himself small, dips, slides, takes the feet back with him and nullifies the aggression in pockets that Shariashvili has shown.
Yeah, there's been variation of defence, like you say. Moving side to side, as we see at the start of the round, just gliding out of range. Missing with the jab there. Al Belushi, and again, really, really on the retreat now, Shariashvili. No intentions whatsoever of engaging with Al Belushi. Been impressed with a little short right counter to the body from Al Belushi. Picks that shot really, really well. When he takes his head offline, I'm surprised he didn't throw it there. Slips inside, or outside rather, with the jab and fires in a nice short right to the body. Got to be careful though, moving forward with that low lead hand. Someone with a bit more speed and accuracy, they'll be looking for that right hand over the top, certainly out of the orthodox stance. But if you're Al Belushi or a fan or the coach of Al Belushi, there's a lot to work with. You know, there's a great future, we believe, for Middle Eastern boxing, like we touched on at the top of the show. So future could be bright for this young man.
Yeah, he's been in control through the better part of these six rounds as we enter the final minute of the contest. Shariashvili trying to keep himself safe now, just moving clockwise around the outside of the ring, just changing direction. Al Belushi going with him, looking to set that right hand up. There it is, you can see him loading up for it, just trying to touch with the jab and then load it up. But Shariashvili, not been easy to catch clean at range with that right hand. He caught a clean one, it was almost a right hook really when they were up close in the last round, and that just momentarily slowed him down. But again, he's been drifting away to his left hand side. Because he is tall, that head is a long, long way away, not easy for Al Belushi to get in range and to land that. But now just trying to shorten those shots up. Shariashvili keeping the hands tight, fires back with a right hand.
He's feeling the pace now. Last 13 seconds of the fight, he's moved non-stop throughout. He's tried, see there again with the right uppercut and the left hook, he'll jump in with 3-4 shots. You know, he's played his part, he'll learn from this Al Belushi.
Yeah, pockets of resistance from the Georgian, but it was nigh on complete control from the Emirati kid. for Hardal Blue Sheep. No doubt this man will be moving to 11-1 in just a few moments' time. First of four contests here on Before the Bell in the books. Campbell Hatton, Aki Fiaz, Sultan Al Nuaimi still to come. We kick off the live feed on the zone at around 9:30 local time here in Abu Dhabi, whatever that translates to in your corner of the world. Khalid Yafai back in action after 2 years of inactivity through the pandemic and after losing his long-held WBA super flyweight title against one of the all-time legends of the modern game in Roman Gonzalez in a ninth round shootout in which he was stopped. He's now campaigning up at 118 pounds and well, with Naoya Inoue expected to do a comprehensive job on Paul Butler in the coming weeks, could he move up to 122, splinter those belts and offer big opportunities for former champion Yafai? He's up against Gerald Paklar from the Philippines, first up on the bill. And then Majid Al-Nakbi, the other Emirati fighter from Dubai, will be second on the bill against John Lawrence Ordonio. All to come ahead of some big, big fights live on the Zoners. For Hardal Blue Sheet and Irakli Shariasvili, just exchange pleasantries, head to centre of the ring. And we have the scorecard. So without further ado, let's head over to David.
Ladies and gentlemen, after six rounds of action here in Abu Dhabi, we go to the judges' score totals, and they read as follows. Waleed Shahabi, 60-54. Juan Carlos Pelayo and Gary Kitanowski both scored about 59-55. All three for your winner by unanimous decision from Dubai, UAE, Kid Emirati, Fahad Al-Blushi.
So 11-1 for young Fahad Al-Blushi. He's been waiting a week for this opportunity. He's got a win in comprehensive style. And he will feel that he's impressed enough to come back and have an opportunity again. It's David Diamante to his right, and he'll be sitting down with his stable mates watching championship boxing action later on. IBF Super Featherweight World title, undisputed titles at 140 pounds, and of course the WBA Light Heavyweight Championship. Darren, talk us through what we just saw over the last six rounds.
I mean, look, it was a frustrating early few rounds, I felt, for Al-Blushi. Purely